welcome. On behalf of Mrs. Farina, Mrs. Fulton, and myself, Mr. Magnuson, I want to welcome everyone to our 17th annual Fine Arts Festival, showcasing student artwork, writing, video, audio, and senior portfolio entries located here in the lobby of our Port Huron High's Performing Arts Center. At this time, I'd like to introduce our superintendent of Port Huron Area School District, Mr. Ron Wolleen, who would like to say a few words.
Good morning. And you know, it's always great to be back here in Big Red Country. And do you know why? Do you know why? Because Port Huron High School is one of the finest high schools in the state of Michigan, bar none. And it's because of these students. I would be remiss if I didn't give you a little bit of history, because this is 17 years of this wonderful art festival going on. And a mark of a great leader is when they leave, what they started continues to get bigger and better. And Debbie Ladensack used to be an English teacher here. Now she's the principal at Fort Gratiot. And 17 years ago, she started this. And I know she's not here this morning, but I know it's being filmed and she'll watch this. So let's give Mrs. Ladensack a nice round of applause. Now, the most important thing, the students. Your work is absolutely amazing. I had the opportunity to walk around and look at all the work, and I tell you, and I mean, there's good schools, and what makes a good school a great school is a tremendous fine arts program, and it's right here. And I gotta tell you a secret, because you know, we're all art people. I'm a fine arts major. I was an art teacher. And what we're doing quietly, we're getting our people in high positions because we're taking over. So with that, I couldn't be happier to be with you today, because truly, I want you to follow your heart and your compassion with whatever type of art that you're really getting involved in, because it truly, I mean, art's all around us. And when you look at, there's not one thing that's not connected to art. I mean, we're sitting in this, you know, Performing Arts Center right now, and just the design and everything else. So there's so much that you have the opportunity to contribute. So I wish you the very best, and I'm just couldn't be happier with the instructors here. You have, and I travel the state, I go all over, you have probably the best instructional staff here that I've seen in many, many years. And let's give our art teacher and instructor a nice round of applause. With that, as always, go Big Reds, and I have the opportunity to introduce the principal of Port Huron High School, Jan Barrett. Jan.
Good morning, everyone. Students, parents, staff, good morning, and welcome to the 17th Annual Fine Arts Festival. And I also would like to extend a very special thank you to three of my colleagues who have given unselfishly of their time and talent to make today a reality. Mrs. Jeannie Fulton, Mrs. Marie Farina, and the man whose creative spirit has been the unifying force behind each of the 17 festivals, Mr. Scott Magnuson. Thank you. Thank you for your unwavering commitment to our students, our most priceless asset. And students, you are priceless. Your creative genius is an inspiration to all. I watched your classmates come down and peruse the artwork, and they are truly impressed by what you have created. Picasso once reminded us that all children are artists. The problem is how to remain an artist once the child grows up. I'm thrilled to know that each of you has found a way to keep your imagination and your creativity alive. Picasso would be very proud of each of you. And please never lose sight of the power of your imagination and the creative genius that lies within each of you. Enjoy the awards ceremony. And always remember that whether or not you receive a monetary award today, each of you is a winner. And you're a winner because you've discovered your creative potential. So sit back, thank you, enjoy the show, and remember, as always, go Big Reds. Mr. Magnuson.
It truly is a great day today. We've been working on this festival for a long time, and we're glad that you're here today to celebrate with us the 17th Annual Fine Arts Festival. Our logo this year, as you can see on the screen, was designed by a senior in the graphic design class. Her name is Brittany Nalanga. Brittany, come up and receive a framed copy of your poster. I think this is what makes our festival maybe different than others, is that we have our students hang their entire shows, so they have their own ownership to it. And I'd like to announce your names of the students. I know not all of you got into the picture. I apologize for that, but please stand when I call your name so we can thank you for all your help that you did this past Monday setting up the show. Raven Burkett. Courtney Leskus. Aubrey Forsythe. Marissa Wood. Joshua Walrich. Brittany Nalanga. Kelly Benton. Chelsea Sherman, Jade Roan, Katie Nitsky, Caitlin Roller, Jamie Tuffin, Emma Lanibi, Callie Ratchi, Dan Logan, Taylor Marsh, Cheyenne Como. And if you also were not on this list but helped, please stand up. Okay. Thank you again for all your help. We had the privilege of having 8 judges this year, and we had Mr. Ken Kraft, Mrs. Leslie Straub, Mrs. Cindy Badley, Ms. Liz Wilcombe, Mrs. Jody Parman-Hosein, Mr. Roger Hansel, Ms. Lisa Huber, and Dennis Snyder. With such a large show, the judging time can take many hours, and we appreciate their time, so we would like to thank them. Can you give them a hand? We want to just say a few words about our silent auction. Our second annual auction happened at the end of April this year, where we sold or auctioned off over 50 pieces of artwork to raise the money for your prize money. So thanks again for all those who supported the silent auction. At this time, we are going to hand out our Fine Arts Festival certificates. Mrs. Fulton will announce the A's through H's. Mrs. Farina will announce I through Q's, and Mr. Magnuson will announce R through Z.
All right, good morning. I'm going to start with Caitlin Adams. And actually, if I could get you to hold your applause, that'd be great. Otherwise, we're going to be here till sixth hour. All right. Tony Aguinagua. Haley Alderman. Devin Andreessen. Ben Armitage. Nicole Baker. Sydney Barnes. Jessica Barty. Keenan Beals. Tarshana Bell. Savannah Bentz. Kelly Benton. Emily Bitzinger. Allie Blauvelt. Aaron Bowden. Kayla Brockett. Kayla Brown. Alejandro Bueno. Denise Bulanda. If you could quiet down, and if the C's and D's could make their way down to the right of the stage, and if you could alphabetize yourself, that would be great. Quietly, please. Raven Burkett. Ryan Burrell. James Calvert. Victoria Chandler. Violetta Shavaria. Shanae Cola. Ashley Collins. Brittany Collins. Cheyenne Como. Jennifer Conley. John Crawford. Stephanie Creech. Paige Darling. Darian Davis. Tyler DeBuff. Zach DeBuff. Viola Dietlin. Angel Doan. If the E, F, and G's could come up to the right of the stage, please. Quietly, please. Sabrina Dorsey. Kylie Dove. Richard Drummond. Kulemba. Anastasia Eagle. Amanda Icarius. Esther Eihorn. Christiana Elling. Brad Elliott. Ashley Ernst. Shanice Irvin. Casey Esquivel. Michaela Evans. Yes. Adriana Irvin.
Just tell her we'll put her on.
So this one's wrong.
I don't know.
Laura Forsman.
We have to print you out one. Okay.
Congratulations.
Aubrey Forsythe. Let's quiet down, please. Thank you. Ashley Fox. Leah Fryer. Jessica Fye. Marissa Garsley. Taylor Garza, Brad Gina, Antonio Goble, Shelby Gonzalez, Jimmy Gould. Amber Green. If we could have the AHIs and J's, please. Michael Gross.
Oh, did you not announce the G's to
the
class?
I thought you did. Yeah, I said the F and G.
And then you're doing the H's?
No, I got the H's.
I'm doing the I guess I'm doing
the Quiet, please. Thank you. Brianna Hansen. Damone Hardy. Courtney Harris. Alicia Hartwig. Melissa Harville. Sean Hatch. Caitlin Heath. Shanice Hill. Megan Hillman.
John?
Mitchell Hills. Brandon Hinojosa. Jessica Hinojosa. Taylor Horbs. Michael Horsey. Garrick Hunger. Jordan Hunt.
You know,
Can we be quiet, please? Gabrielle Ingram. Chase Jower. Samantha Johnson. Alexis Johnson. Bridget Johnson. Damon Jones. Rebecca Jones. Terrell Jones. Terrell. Thomas Jones. Ashley Kammer. Gabrielle Kasten. Sorry. William Keane. Tommy Kennedy. Aaron Kilborn. Katie Kinzel. Emily Kleba. Mackenzie Klein. Stephen Nabenshu. Jamie Kobe. Can you be quiet? Shh. Patricia Caroli. Madeline Korth. Caitlin Kotsky. Ashley Kramer. Vanessa Kretschmann. Alexander Langdoff. Langdoff. Charles Lashbrook. Katie Lester. Courtney Letzkas. Danny Logan. Ashley Lukes. Kayla Lowe. Lena Liu.
Do I have P's?
Should I get the M's and the P's? Could you line up? Mara Mardini, Taylor Marsh, Shauna May, Breland McMillan, Melissa Lash, Dakota Miller. Tyler Miller. Can you be quiet, please? Darshell Mitchell.
Oops.
Antonio Moncrief.
Name again, come up for that one.
J. Joe Mund. Ashley Murdoch. Nolan Murphy. Brittany Nalanga. Lizeth Navarro. Katie Nitsky. Lenitra Nixon. Jacqueline Neves.
Yeah, is that how you say it? Oops.
Kyle Nugent. Quiet, please. Rachel Ochoa. Congratulations. Jesse Pert. How do you say this?
Pincombe.
Robert Pincombe. Carmen Payunk. Nick Petrie. Feliciana Porchman. Morgan Potts. Paige Precor. Sarah Prey. Jason Pringle. Lauren Pringle. Graham Prout.
What?
Can we have the Q's and R's line up, please?
So we're starting with the R's, Daniel Raines. Devante Reyes. Alicia Randolph. Callie Rachi. Natasha Recker. Jane Rohn. Tiffany Rich. John Ross. Katie Radzinski. Misty Sanders. If you could keep it down, please. Katie Sanderson. Amari Searles. Jacob Sexton. Elizabeth Sherlock. Shania Sherlock. Chelsea Sherman. Carly Schrader. Cecilia Schuller. John Sinkusix. Patricia Sahula. Sorry. Jessica Smith. Yeah. Roger Socia. Juliana Soy. Elias Spots. Brendan Stevens. Aaron Sterling. Sam Steyer. Ariana Streeter. Rebecca Sturges. Jessica Swartz. If we can have T through Z come up. Dustin Swinson. Ryan Swinson. Hope Telfer. Janie Thibodeau. David Tiki. Tyler Tiki. Justine Tumalo. Tyler Traska. Jamie Tuffin. Rachel Umphrey. Ryan Urban. Keenan Visca. Joshua Walrich. Doc Walker. Jake Walpole. Michael Walsh. Jesse Walters. Doc. Chris Warzynski. Chris DeWeedy. Eric Werner. Kenya Witcher. Sierra White. Danielle Wickings. Cheyenne Willing. Hannah Winkler. Julius Winkowski. Marissa Wood. Anthony Rimblowski. Ann Yoder. And Jordan Zach. This is spelled wrong.
Oh.
It's just Z-A-K. Early this fall, we had several pieces of artwork on display at the Studio 1219 Gallery, and several students received honorable mentions, and six students won free classes. Please come up to get your ribbon when your name is called.
Tarshana Bell. Congratulations. Chase Jaywar. Amanda Stevens.
If you see your name on the screen, you can go ahead and start coming down now. Okay, so first I have Cheyenne Como. Tiffany Rich. Jackie Nieves. Michelle Picaro. Lizeth Navarro. Ashley Kamer. Taylor Kinter. And Shania Sherlock.
Also, if you see your name listed up on the screen right now, please start making your way down. We have two ribbons for Ryan Swinson. I have two ribbons also for Anastasia Eagle. Holly O'Neill. There you go. One ribbon for Devin Andreessen. One ribbon for Marissa Wood. Here you go. Devin. I have two ribbons for Shelby Gonzalez. Jason Pringle has one ribbon. Chelsea Sherman. Esther Eichhorn. I have one ribbon for Darshell Mitchell. Chelsea. And two ribbons for Joshua Walrich.
Thank you.
That piece is going to go a long way. At this time, Mrs. Farina is going to present certificates for the Homeless Awareness Poster Contest.
My students from last semester participated in Homeless Awareness Week, and they had the opportunity to design a poster of what homelessness meant to them. They had three winners that won prizes, and if I could have them stand, that would be Tarshana Bell. Yeah! Michael Sofa. and Janelle Moncrief. Now, the following students, I have certificates of participation. So the following students can come up and receive their certificate. Sydney Barnes. Shanice Irvin. Nia Moncrief. Ashley Ernst. Danielle Wickings. Jacob Hildinger. Jared Barnes. John Derrick. Mark Drown.
These kids probably aren't here.
Naraya Meadows. Daniel Drew. Cody Cramp. Sierra Cates. Caitlin Amy. Carrie Tucker. Bethany Murdoch. Callie Plant. Kendra Easton. Kyle Bankston. Megan Bowen. Cheyenne Collingwood. Chris Holberg. Justin Beavington. Jeremy Kasich. Jake Jones. Emma Emery. Desiree Campbell. Allison Huddy. Alisa Morris. Nick Mosier. Samantha Smades. Taylor Baldwin. Chelsea Kelly. Tori Greer. And Janelle Moncrief.
Just when you thought we were done with certificates, this year we had 101 pieces of student artwork that were displayed at St. Clair Community College during March and April in the Beatrice Thornton Student Art Exhibit. We will announce the names. Please come up to receive your certificate.
You want me to do mine?
Ashley Murdoch. Ryan Urban. Joshua Walrich. Jason Pringle. Holly O'Neill. Ryan Swinson. Jessica Schwartz. Laura Forsman, Raven Burkett, Aaron Bowden, Garrett Hunger, Courtney Harris. Marissa Wood. Dustin Swinson. Aubrey Forsythe. Esther Eichhorn. Darian Davis. Terrell Jones. William Kern. Jordan Hunt. Jessica Smith. Feliciana Porchman. Bradley Gina. Darshell Mitchell. Courtney Leskis. Shelby Gonzalez. Chelsea Sherman. Brittany Nalanga. Kelly Betton. Brandon Hinojosa. Eric Werner. Ashley Fox. Anastasia Eagle. Cheyenne Willing. Thomas Jones.
Amanda Stevens.
Oops.
Emma Emery. Caitlin Heath. David Tiki. Tarshana Bell. Shanice Irvin. Bridget Johnson. Amber Green. Erica Oriel. Megan Bowen. Stephanie Creech. Chase Jauer. Samantha Johnson. James Gould. Ashley Collins. Alicia Randolph. Jeremy Kasich. Andrea Pert. Nolan Murphy.
All right, hello again. These are mainly ceramics, but there are some drawing certificates also. Janelle Ross. Patricia Sawilla. Stephanie Creech. Savannah Bentz. Michelle Picaro. Jessica Barty, Sean Hatch, Chelsea Sherman, Brittany Tulloch.
I know she's not here.
Tyler DeBuff. Michael Horsey. Taylor McKenzie. Damone Hardy. Sam Steyer. Tiffany Rich. Taylor Kinter. Chris Wozinski. Jonathan Cook. Jeff Monzo. Lenitra Nixon. Angel Doan. Damon Jones. If we could quiet down again, please. Paige Precor. Jackie Nieves. Misty Sanders. Kelsey Kemp. Taylor Marsh. Justine Tamalo. Denise Bulanda. Jason Pringle. Ashley Kamer. Tyler Tiki. Maddie Korth. James Calvert. Denise Bulanda. Nick Petrie. Patricia Caroli. Callie Ratchie. Tom Jones. And Aaron Bowden. Let's give a round of applause for all the last certificates.
And now we come to what you're really interested in, are the awards. I will announce the writing awards, if everyone is quiet, please, as well as the audio and video awards. I'm not sure if you recognized a few of the audio entries when you entered the auditorium today. We had Dakota Miller, her one and only, Lena Lou, her Hamburger Sonnet, and Jesse Pert's Good Times playing. Mrs. Ladensack could not attend today, but we will award the best of show and writing. Mrs. Ladensack started this festival in 1995, where we held the first show in the Media Center. So, first of all, we are going to award the poetry, 9th through 12th grade. In third place, we have a piece called Fingers by Kayla Kelly. Have you come up for your awards? Okay. So second place for poetry 9th through 12th, the piece is entitled Anger by Cheyenne Willing. And first place for the poetry category goes to a poem called Touches Analogy by Leanne Lum.
No, you could do it.
No, just a little bit. We're going to have Leanne read just a little bit. Maybe just part of it.
Okay, can I read to here?
Yeah.
Okay.
Just get up real close.
Okay. Okay, my poem's called Touches Analogy. Reflecting the ripened rays of sun into mine eyes and pouring the blooming buds of light onto my skin, I have known no more than a soft touch upon my cheek. But only for a moment does your kiss flutter upon my flesh. The cool trickle of water as it washes down the fingertips of trees, and the current tears that a child cries quietly into the night. The whisper of words throughout the winding woods and the smooth sand upon a salty seashore. The crisp calls of chords in the calm daytime and the delicious deliberation during a downy dream. The way a painter prodigiously prompts a perfect art piece and the thought that thrives on the laughter and love of a heart.
Okay, now we're going to go on to fiction 9 through 12. Third place goes to a piece entitled Like Fire and Ice by Jennifer Lowe. Continuing into fiction, our second place goes to Alex Olson, See You Later. Congratulations. And first place for the fiction category entitled Willie's Life Lessons by Jessica Schwartz.
Okay, mine's Willie's Life Lessons, and I'll just read the first paragraph. William Stratton, Willie for short, is a smart boy. Witty and intelligent is what his teachers say. A real prodigy he is. They say that to him all the time, praising him, congratulating him for being top of his class. It's what teachers are supposed to do, he guesses. Make sure kids' self-esteem are high and keep the smiles on the 10-year-olds' faces. And that was the first paragraph, so.
Thank you. And now for the last writing award, we have the Deborah Ladensack Best to Show. And this is the piece that she scored the highest out of all the writing entries. And it doesn't always have to be the number one place. This year's Best of Show will go to a piece called Anger by Cheyenne Willing. This plaque is on display in the Media Center, and it will have your name engraved in it. Cheyenne? We're going to have Cheyenne read it. Come on.
Ooh, I don't want to read that.
Anger. It tastes like biting into raw meat like a wild animal or a cannibal, slaughtering and eating its food like it's never eaten before. Never any pity or regret, never backing down, never being afraid. Even with the irony blood taste shrouding your mouth, you just want more with every bite you take.
Thank you. And now we are going on to the audio entries for this year's Fine Arts Festival. In third place for her piece called One and Only, Dakota Miller. And second place goes for a wonderful flute soloist, Lena Liu. And first place for a piece called Good Times, Jesse Pert. Congratulations. We'll try to play it a little later. Well, for the first time, we're going to play the winning video entries. So for third place, third place, Kylie Dove, Let's Play a Love Game.
Hey y'all, I'm your host, MTV VJ Tatiana Rapatana, and this is Let's Play a Love Game. You know what it is. We take one lucky chica, three famous players, we separate them, she asks them some cues, and picks who she'd be digging the most. But hold up. Here's the catch. She ain't be knowing who they is. Let's take a look at our contestants today. So
we're still playing.
today I has with me my homegirl, Tiffany.
It's Tiffany.
Okay, so anyway, she be looking for love. Tiffany is a newly single shorty with a passion for water skiing, Italian food, and she be hating on cussing, lazy cartoon characters. Hey, Tiffany.
Hi.
So, is you ready to find the love of your life?
Yes, Tatiana, I am ready to find my one true love.
Aight, so, we got three contestants right on the other side of this wall. Start asking your cues, girl.
Okay, contestant number one, if you had $1 million, what would you do with it?
I would like to open a center for kids who can't read good and want to learn to do good things.
Oh, that's sweet of you, contestant number one. How thoughtful. So, contestant number two, where would you take me on a date?
Well, first I'd let you take a ride on my Nimbus 2000. After that, I'd let you play with my wand a little. And then I'd end the magical night by taking you to Hogsmeade for a butterbeer.
All right, contestant number two, sounds like you know how to entertain a lady. So, contestant number three, what is your biggest flaw?
Biggest flaw? Well, that's a tough one. Biggest flaw, well, you know, I guess I'd have to say I'm just so cool that it makes other kids feel bad.
Well, contestant number three, I suppose that's considered a flaw. So back to you, contestant number one. If you could make the whole world listen to one word of advice, what would it be?
Well, Tiffany, I'd have to tell the world that there's more to life than being really, really ridiculously good looking.
That's very touching, contestant number one. So contestant number two, I really love water skiing to stay in shape. Are you in any sports?
Well, I dabbled in Quidditch. I was the youngest seeker of the year, actually.
Never heard of that sport. Contestant number two, but it sounds like you're pretty good at it. Contestant number three, who is your hero?
You know, this might sound kind of egotistical, but I'd have to say it myself. It's only because, like, if you could really see me, I actually do really cool stuff, and most of the kids think I'm really cool, and I'm like, basically, everything about me is just so cool. I'm just cool all the time.
I see.
So, Tiffany, I think the time has come for you to choose your dream boo. So, who gonna be?
Well, I've thought it over and I've made my decision. Contestant number one is a selfish egomaniac. I mean, get over yourself. Contestant number two, you're a joke. Have you ever met a woman besides your mother?
Lord Voldemort killed my mom.
Contestant number three, you seem like a really caring, selfless person with a lot to offer. I choose you.
Heck yeah! Respect my authority! Yeah. Well, hello, little female.
Are you kidding me? I hate South Park. My ex-boyfriend used to watch it all the time. I'm done.
What? Screw you guys. I'm going home. Screw you guys.
Bam. Well, that's our show, y'all. Tune in next week to see if our lucky contestant chooses Borat, Annie Milonakis, or Hannah Montana.
And our second place video entry goes to a video called Calculus in Real Life by John Sienkiewicz. Yep, congratulations. in our number one first place entry this year for the video entry goes to Emily Bitzinger, Told You, A Lesson in Theater Etiquette. So let's continue, guys, if you can be quiet. Our art entries keep changing from 138 entries in 1998 to 418 in 2007. Our highest number to date was in 2008 with 490 entries. This year we have 364 entries and a total of 226 students represented in our show. It's changed in size due mostly because we have semester classes. It is my distinct pleasure to announce the Art Awards this year with the help of Mrs. Eugenia Fulton and Mrs. Marie Farina. The Art Department has had many fine awards and contests, but first a few thank yous. First of all, I want to thank Ms. Sarah Jo Friend for organizing this year's writing entries. The writing booklets out in the lobby and organizing the judges and the writing results. Thanks again, Sarah Jo. And to Mrs. Fulton and Mrs. Farina for all the hours we did after school and weekends matting and preparing the entries for the festival. The show wouldn't be as successful without all your help. Thanks. I also want to thank Mark and Denise for all the extra work and coordination in making this exhibit and this awards ceremony successful, and especially to Ms. Barrett for all her support of the arts also. And now, the Art Awards. We do want to mention that this year's Christmas card was designed by Tyler Mueller. Tyler, stand up. And we designed a new art brochure, and the winner for the design was Raven Burkett. Raven, stand up. We have all brand new names and a new curriculum, and we're pretty excited about all the changes. So look for the brochure to explain all the different classes. We do want to go through just what happened in the Fall Scholastic Art Awards. And when your name is called, just stand up. For certificate in drawing, Ashley Fox. A certificate in painting goes to Anastasia Eagle. A certificate in ceramic and glass goes to Ashley Kamer. Certificate in photography goes to Jessica Smith. Silver key in painting goes to Shelby Gonzalez. Gold key in painting goes to Devin Andreessen. Gold Key in digital art goes to Richard Drummond. Another gold key in digital art goes to Eric Werner. A certificate in ceramic and glass goes to Tyler Tiki. And also a gold key in ceramic and glass goes to Tyler. Certificate in digital art goes to Justine Tumalo. And also to Justine, one of our Gold Key Portfolio winners. Certificate in sculpture to Chelsea Sherman. And Chelsea also was awarded a Gold Key for her portfolio. A certificate in digital art, Joshua Walrich. He also won a silver key in digital art. And also won a gold key in his portfolio. We had a certificate in ceramic and glass from Kelly Benton. And Kelly won a gold key in printmaking. And also in ceramic and glass. We also wanted to mention last year we had a national winner that was awarded during the summer. Cody Fye designed this poster and it won first place in the country. And he won well over $1,000 for this, but we don't have the results for this year's contest, so look forward to next year. Maybe we'll do the same. We had a winner for a Thumb Fest. It was a acoustical guitar logo done by Joshua Walrich. And now on to the Art Awards. The first category is AB painting, 9th through 12th, and third place goes to a piece called Beauty and Color by Thomas Jones. We had such wonderful paintings this year. It was very hard for the judges to decide, but second place goes to a piece called Woman in Hat by Aubrey Forsythe. And first place for a painting called Tat by Anastasia Eagle. On to pencil for 9th and 10th grade. Third place for a piece called A Great Leader by Damon Jones. And for second place, titled Candy by Anastasia Eagle. In first place, for a black and white grid drawing, Alexis Johnson. And on to category D, pencil, 11th and 12th grade. Third place, for a pastel drawing called Pastel Girl, Esther Eichhorn. Second place, for a piece entitled Still Life of Glass and Fruit, Ashley Fox. In first place, for a color pencil drawing called Crayons, Raven Burkett. Okay, for categories E and F, ink for 9th through 12th, third place for a piece called Labradot, Aaron Bowden. Second place goes to a piece entitled At the Beginning, Laura Forsman. In first place for an untitled piece by Anastasia Eagle. On to the category G, ceramics, 9th and 10th. Third place is awarded to a piece entitled Fish Coil Pot, Melissa Harvell. Second place in ceramics, 9th through 10th, is awarded to a piece entitled Nature's Coils by Jessica Fai. And our winner, first place in the ceramic category, entitled Autumn, Taylor Marsh. Under the category H for ceramics, 11th and 12th grade. Third place is awarded to Ashley Kamer's Earth Freckles. Second place in ceramics, 11th and 12th, for a piece entitled Fuego en la Grande, Jacqueline Knives. In first place, entitled The Undescribable by James Calvert. we continue on with the sculptures categories. I category, 9th and 10th. Third place for a piece called Tile Tree by Lizeth Navarro. Second place is awarded to a piece entitled Dark Joy, Jessica Bardi. And our first place for sculpture 9 through 10th goes to a piece entitled Gnome, Paige Precor. Continuing with J category, sculpture 11 through 12, third place, entitled The Light of the Storm by Denise Bolanda. So many wonderful sculptures in this category. The second place goes to Fossilized by Thomas Jones. In our first place for sculpture 11th and 12th for a piece entitled Eye of Egypt, Robert Pinkham. Continuing with categories K through L, other mediums for 9th through 12th, third place for a batik called Henna Tree, Aubrey Forsythe. Second place for another beautiful batik entitled Fish in Black Waters, Feliciana Porchman. In first place for the other categories, 9th through 12th, goes to The Harpist by Chelsea Sherman. Another very popular category, photography, category M, again, 9th through 12th grade. Third place goes to a photo entitled Vanishing Broadway by Michael Horsey. And second place goes to a piece called Michigan by Jessica Smith. And our first place for photography this year goes to a photograph entitled Flipped by Haley Alderman. Congratulations. Now we'll continue with category N, graphic design, also 9th through 12th grade, third place for a piece entitled Dandelion by Leah Fry. Second place in graphic design goes to a piece entitled Blue by Hope Telfer. And our first place in graphic design this year goes to a piece entitled Doll's Face by Jordan Hunt. Our last category, at least in the main draw, is O for computer art, 9th through 12th, third place, for a piece entitled The Soul of Music, Darshell Mitchell. Second place is awarded to Animation by Ryan Swinson. Okay. And our first place in computer art goes to a piece entitled Putting Together the Pieces by Ashley Murdoch. And now to our best displayed senior portfolios. We had 17 portfolios displayed this year. Hopefully you'll have a chance to look at them before they take them down. I just wanted to mention that all 8 judges had a different first place. But for third place, the judges awarded to Shelby Gonzalez. Second place goes to Brittany Nalanga. And our first place for best displayed senior portfolio this year goes to Joshua Walrich. And my last award that I'm going to announce is my Best of Show, the Scott Magnuson Best of Show. It was awarded the most first places from all eight judges. It goes to a painting called Tat by Anastasia Eagle. And her award will be on display in room 406. Her name will be monogrammed. And now Mrs. Fulton will bring up her favorite honorable mentions.
Okay, every year after the show has been, you know, we've made all the decisions, or the judges have made all the decisions on the places, I always go back through and it's like, what? That one didn't get a prize? What? That, you know, I know all the hard work everybody puts into it, so then we started doing honorable mentions. So not every category has one and some have two. So for pencil, Kenya Witcher. And Katie Nitsky. For the ink category, Sarah Prey. And computer art, Brad Elliott. In photography, Ariana Streeter. In ceramics, Graham Prout. In sculpture, I have two, Aaliyah Spots and Jamie Tuffin. In other mediums, Paige Precor and Esther Ehorn. And for senior portfolio, Kelly Benton.
Before we all leave, there's just a couple announcements. First of all, thanks for coming, and underclassmen, prepare for next year. Think about doing a senior portfolio. We need everyone to leave their artwork up since the show is going to be on display for this Monday's school board meeting. We're trying to get as many people in the community to come and see our show, and you will have your work returned early next week. When we return your artwork, if you would like the mat around it, the mat will be $1 for small and medium sizes and $2 for large sizes. If you do not want the mat, we will return your artwork without it.